Let's play video games!
Hello, and welcome back to Hard On Gaming, where the games are hard and so am I. I'm your host, BigStiffy, and this is Dwarfcraft, my modded Minecraft Let's Play. Last episode, I kind of got my ass kicked by some big asshole minotaur. Yeah, look at this fucking piece of shit. Oh, fuck. Oh my god! Ugh. I have slowness, mining fatigue, and I am on 1 HP. That big bastard. Oh god, how the fuck am I going to do anything? Oh, wait a minute. That's right! I have this. So let's see. Opens temporary doors on rifts. And has a teleport attack. Let's see. If I use it on this big bastard. Come here. Oh, come on. Fuck off. You piece of shit. I hate you. Nope, he'll come right the fuck over. Look at this. This fucking asshole is dancing on my grave. Jesus Christ. How the hell do I get rid of him? Hey, fuckhead, come over here. Come here. Damn it. Don't fucking dance on it, you piece of shit. Oh, fuck. That was like the one thing I thought was going to be my saving grace. Oh, hell. Now what do I do? I don't have a fucking pickaxe. I don't have fucking anything. What the hell is his fucking health at? Oh, Jesus!
No. No.
Oh, fuck off. God damn it.
No.
Fuck you. Don't fucking moo at me. Come on, follow me, dumbass. Come here. Come here. Yeah, come over here. Come on. What the hell is stopping you, piece of shit? Look at this. This guy is such a fucking big bastard. Maybe, just maybe, I can get all my stuff back before he realizes. Oh, no. No. Run. Run, damn it. Jump in the water. Oh, my God. Even the water, he's quick.
No. No. No.
Oh my god. No. Come on. No. No. No, get away. Get away.
No.
Aim for the head. It's not working. Aim for the nuts.
No.
Nothing works.
No.
Oh god, I hate minotaurs.
No.
So much.
No.
I'm gonna waste all my fucking arrows on him. Oh god, how much fucking health does he have? Oh, I'm out of arrows. Shit, no. How much fucking health do you have left? Good lord. Come on, he's almost dead. Come on. I did it! Holy Christ on a cracker. That was fucking ridiculous. Okay, now that I've got my stuff back and completely forgotten what I'm supposed to be doing, Jesus Christ. Can't believe that. Minotaurs are just the worst goddamn thing ever. They're the biggest of bastards. Right next to the Himalayan snow monkey. Or whatever the hell it is. The abominable snow gorilla. So anyway, I've gotten a job recently. It's a pretty tough job, actually, but it'll make me some money in the short run, at least. But Jesus Christ! In the meantime, like I've not gotten paid yet, but I'm just getting so goddamn beat up from this job. I have huge black and blue marks all over the place. it honestly is almost like I'm going to a fight club to earn money, but I wish it was that simple, but no. In reality, it's just from moving a lot of heavy stuff and clearly doing it wrong that I get all these black and blue marks. And aside from that, one thing that hadn't occurred to me when I took this job was the fact that maybe, just maybe, I should have a tetanus shot, considering that I will be working amongst a lot of potentially rusty stuff. Oh, that fucking chicken just got out. Alright, well, I'm not worried about it. But yeah, I'm working around a lot of potentially rusty objects, and I think I got a spider in my ear. Or maybe it was just hair. But anyway. Throughout the week, I mean, I don't... Monday through Thursday, I don't really work around a lot of stuff. But on Fridays, I might be working on lots of rusty stuff. Or potentially stepping on rusty nails. Which has me pretty concerned, for the most part, because I haven't had a tetanus shot in I don't know how long. It's been probably years. In fact, I don't think I've had a tetanus shot since grade school, and hell if I can remember how long ago that was. But I would really hate to fucking, like, stab myself with something covered in rust and end up getting tetanus. Apparently, though, you can get a tetanus shot within the first 48 hours of like, getting injured on something rusty. So, that's something, but I'd rather be prepared for it ahead of time. Rather than, you know, take my chances and get a tetanus shot after the fact that I stabbed myself by being stupid. So, yeah, that's something that I'm gonna have to get done pretty soon. I have to see if my workplace will actually cover it, despite the fact that it's only a temp job. And if not, well, it's just no good. Because tetanus shot's like 80 bucks, I think. Oh shit. Maybe I shouldn't have used up all those arrows. But yeah, tetanus shot's about $80. Which, I actually thought that tetanus shots were free, but apparently that's not the case. But, I mean, anyway, you know, I'm getting paid for this job, so after I get paid, I'll be able to, like, I can afford it before I get paid, but, you know, I can get reimbursed, I guess. Despite the fact that, you know, your workplace should provide you with that kind of medical care if you're going to be working with rusty shit like that. But whatever. Whatever, man. Now I got a ton of wheat. Oh yeah, I guess I should breed some cows together. Now, many of my videos are going to be temporarily pretty short, about only 15 minutes or so. And it's all due to the time restrictions that I have when trying to work around my daily life and my job. So I don't have the time to do a lot of stuff during the week now, so I'm trying to get stuff accomplished on the weekends, because I don't have time otherwise to do stuff. Don't run. Nice, I got two arrows. So yeah, during the weekend I try to accomplish all the chores that need to be done. And on top of all that, like, I don't have much time to record anything at all, much less edit the stuff that I do record. Where are the ropes for these cows? Let's close that. I don't actually see the ropes anywhere. Why don't I see the ropes? That's a bit concerning. Oh well, I guess I'm not really gonna worry about it. So I guess one thing that I wanted to get done, I wanted to get a hammer made. So I got the steel hammerhead. Let's see. And on top of that, I have to get two plates. So let's throw a stone hammerhead in there. Let's gotta get some plates. What am I gonna make those out of? The handle I really want to make out of slime crystals, because then that will have a really high durability. The plates, I think I got one angmalon. That adds mining speed 10. Now. Oh man, do I have any silver? No, I don't have any silver. Because if I make electrum, that's actually pretty good for a large plate. Where is it? Here it is. So durability is only 100, but mining speed is 20. So that's actually really good as far as mining speed goes. But I need silver for that, and it doesn't look like I've managed to find any. That is a bit disappointing. So, yeah. Well, actually, since I do have a horse, I can try and tame it. I have particles decreased, but I don't have it turned off entirely, so let's try and tame a horse. Oh. Are you gonna be happy? Nope. Are you gonna eat all my apples and be an asshole? son of a bitch. Come on. Come on. There we... What? Why'd he kick me off? I saw the hearts. Alright, I guess he's tame now, so that's good. I gotta get a saddle. So how do I make a saddle? I know I can craft them because there's a milk creature saddle. Alright, so I need leather and I need 3 iron ingots. That's not too bad. How much leather do I have, though? I think I used up all the leather that I had. Damn. Alright, so I've got a tame horse now, but I don't actually have a saddle to be able to ride it. Well, that's really annoying. Shit. Alright, well, so much for that plan, I guess. I'm gonna have to put my feathers away, put the seeds away. That. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, I got fire resistance potions. I forgot about that I had those. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to just go with Angmalin as far as my large plates go, because I can always just make a new hammer later. Now, how do I make Angmalin? If I can type at all. Molten Angmalin. I have to melt gold with iron. Alright, so I need 2 gold, 2 iron, and that'll give me 8. If I'm doing things the smart way, which, who knows. I'm gonna have to start breeding these cows together soon, because otherwise I'm just not gonna have enough. I'm not gonna have enough leather. In fact, I guess I should start doing that now. Oh yeah, and another thing I wanted to do was I wanted to actually build a proper barn for housing all my animal friends, which will not always be my animal friends, but may later become my materials or food. Alright, so I got... Damn, I only got 1 slime ball. I forget how much I need to actually make a slime crystal. I think it's 4 slime balls per slime crystal. Because 4 slime, 1 dirt, 1 sand gets you slimy mud. And that 1 slimy mud bakes into a slime crystal. So I need 3 of those for a tough rod, so... Oh boy, I actually need 12 slime balls. Damn it. That's a lot. Shit. Alright, so be it. Oh yeah, I got a miniature yellow heart. Fantastic. I don't think I have anything else, though. Oh yeah, I guess I have to make I have to make a cauldron so I can start making sake. Let's see. Oh yeah, and I also have to get myself a thingamajig. What is it? It's a sigil of something or another. The air sigil. I need to make this, so I need an apprentice blood orb. Oh good, well I just made an emerald with those shards, so I can actually make an apprentice blood orb. That'll be good. So then I can make myself an air sigil and fly up to a slime island. That will be really handy, yes. Let's see, do I have all the, I do. Wait, Angmalin, 4 ingots, what? That doesn't seem right. So I actually needed 4 gold and 4 iron. Did I not calculate that right? I don't know. Alright, so 2 more gold, 2 more iron. I'll have enough for my other large plate. That'll be groovy. Lots of feathers. Getting lots and lots of feathers. Guess I don't really need that many feathers, but whatever. Oh, and I suppose there's also a breeding mechanic for horses, where you have to breed them together to try and get a faster, stronger horse that can jump higher, which I don't know if I'm gonna get into that. That doesn't seem like something I really want to spend too much time on, because if it actually does take into account the base stats of the horses you breed together, just forget it. Just absolutely forget it. I can't be bothered. I'll just ride a slow horse if I need to. Fuck it. Okay. At least I have a tame horse anyway. Alright, so we've got 8 angmelon. Great. Make another angmelon plate, and damn, I don't have anything to use for a tough rod. Damn it. Alright, I'm gonna have to make the air sigil then, and try and do that. And I'll make the apprentice blood orb off camera, because I'm sure nobody wants to watch me sit around and make a fucking, whatchamacallit. Oh wait, I have an apprentice blood orb. Oh man, I just saved myself a whole lot of trouble. Why did I store it in the fucking crafting bench? That was the dumbest thing I could have done. Sweet baby Jesus. Great. Put that in there. Fantastic. So now I got 2 angmelon plates. That'll be good. Use that on my hammer. I got the steel hammerhead. I just need a tough rod. So let's see. What do I need to make for the air sigil with? I need a gas tier, I need 6 feathers, and I need a reinforced slate, so that's not too bad. Do I have a gas tier? I do. I have a single gas tier. Oh! Oh, yes. That's great. Oh, and I'm gonna have to cut the video here. So, you know what? I'll make my thingamajig real quick. And hopefully... where'd it go? What? Oh, that's right. I forgot. Because of the thing here. The hopper duct. Alright, so let's put a feather in there. And blank slate. Come on, reinforced slate. Let's go. I hope there's enough life points in there. Yes! I got it! Oh, shit. I need the feathers! Shit. Alright. I'll make this real quick, and then I'll have to end the video. Because I'm going to have to record other stuff, and I'm also going to have to edit everything. And I want to get all that done in one day, so that I'm not rushing to do it tomorrow. Okay, so let's see. Blank slate. That. This. And a little bit of the other thing, and we got an air sigil! Yes! Fantastic. Alright. So let's see. I'm not sure how many life points I actually have in my pool. I got 1600. Does this say... It doesn't say how much it actually actually costs to use. So... Let's fly up here. Whoa. And that cost 50 life points. Alright, so I'm gonna have to spend a while just accumulating life points with my blood orb. And yeah, that'll be great. Oh shit. Fortunately, it does not stop fall damage, so you actually have to... You have to try and fly towards the ground in order to eliminate the impact, which seems really backwards. But there we go. Managed to get an air sigil, so that's pretty cool. That's pretty much all that I can record for this video. Unfortunately, it has to be a little bit short. So, join me next time for some more Minecraft. Check out some of the other content on my channel if you feel so inclined. I try to keep it fresh and varied. And until next time, take care, Internet. I will see you in space.
I bet you were expecting some sort of fancy outro. Nope. Just this. But hey, you know what would be cool? Clicking one of those links below? Yeah. That'd make it cool.